Hello and welcome to a short what's new video about the recently released version 1.1 of the AluFrame Assistant for SOLIDWORKS. With the new features you will reach your goals even faster than before. For example, you can now combine multiple connectors and add them in just one step. That was fast. I'll show it again on the second profile. While we are up here, let's quickly place an end cap. Okay, the end cap was nothing new, but let's use the same tool again down here to add a foot. In the new version, it's now possible to place several parts, including a cut and a single step. This saves a lot of time. A nice side effect is that this way we can create our 3D sketch from the beginning and the final dimensions of the construction without having to take the height of, for example, feet into account. Profile cuts are not only possible in the end cap function, but also in joints like this T-joint. It is no longer necessary to adjust the profiles first, all machining is done in one single step. Another new function to keep the overview is the Browse Database tool. In the left tab all existing connections are listed and in the right tab all components. Connections that are no longer needed can simply be deleted here, which is straightforward. Since at least I can't always remember which components were used in which connection, the database will help. So if you want to delete a component that is still used in one of the existing connections, you get a warning message that connections that contain this component will also be deleted. To conclude this video, I'll show how easy it is to create drawings including the parts lists from the 3D design. For this I use our first example, because it simply contains more components and thus leads to longer BOMs. First we update the position numbers via the Test Pane tab. Next we use the export function to export the BOM as an Excel spreadsheet. There is a selection of templates from which I choose a suitable one. This is very fast. I open the list so we can have a look at it. Using the standard functions of SOLIDWORKS, we can create a drawing in which we can then insert the parts list. Nothing new here. I just place a few views. Using the Insert menu, we can add the bill of materials, and for this I also use one of our predefined templates. Okay, that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and you can find even more information on our website. Hope to see you next time.